students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode. And in this class, I will be decoding Mullah Omar, A Myth of Convenience, written by Rakesh Sood. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Plus, this is very, very important for Political Science optional students. Now, what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the breaking up of Taliban is going to create a big problem for the entire Middle East countries and for the Asian countries. This editorial is also about how difficult it will be becoming in the days to come to rein in the terrorism in the Middle East and in Asia. Now, this editorial is also about how the strategy to tackle the Taliban, how the strategy to tackle the terrorism has failed, despite US had tried in the past n number of strategies and policies. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to go in the history of how Taliban has incepted. What were the causes behind the birth of Taliban, and why United States of America has failed to rein in this Taliban? Now, Taliban, it was a proxy. It was a terrorist outfit that was created, that was groomed, that was nurtured, that was built, and that was inflated by the twin forces of Pakistan and United States of America. Now, why United States of America had given birth to these terrorist outfits? Now, United States of America, in the past, it had acted in consonance with Pakistan to develop this Taliban. This Taliban was developed to fight against the communist forces. So the birth, the generation of this Taliban is nothing but the result of the attrition between the forces of capitalism and communism. Now, when the fight between capitalism and communism had moderated, and the financing to these terrorist outfits were stopped, it was then when they had begun to backlash its masters. The masters means Pakistan and United States of America. So, as far as Taliban is concerned, it is a fundamentalist Islamic group that wanted to establish the Sharia law, that wanted to set up their own way of system in Afghanistan. Now, this Taliban, it was created in the year 1996 by Mullah Omar with the help of ISI plus United States of America. But as I have told you, this was created to fight against the communist forces. Aur jab ladai khatam ho gaya, ये एक useless entity बन के रह गया United States of America के लिए, तो उन्होंने इनको financing करना, तालिबान को financing करना बंद कर दिया. So they had to take a backlash in the form of 9/11 attack that was done on United States of America in year 2001. Now this attack had changed the symmetries in the entire Asia and the Middle East countries, and in the countries like Iraq and Afghanistan. United States of America invaded Afghanistan to rein in the Taliban, because the Al-Qaeda had acted in consonance with the Taliban to attack United States of America. Now, after venturing into Afghanistan, after trying to rein in the Taliban forces, but ending up being a failure, United States of America tried to treat the path of rapprochement, treat the path of friendliness, treat the path of Bonhome with the Taliban forces. So from about 2011 onwards, जब यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका को रियलाइज हो गया कि हम ये वॉर नहीं जीत सकते तालिबान से, तो 2011 से लेके अब तक उन्होंने दे हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू कंडक्ट टॉक्स विद तालिबान बाय इन्वॉल्विंग आईएसआई. दे हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू एंटर इनटू अ एग्रीमेंट बाय विच a stable government may be established in Afghanistan. क्योंकि आज वहां पे जो terrorist forces है वहां पे सरकार को चलने नहीं दे रहे हैं. पहले हामिद करजई की सरकार थी, अब मिस्टर घानी की सरकार है. Now this Taliban which was united at a point of time, it had splintered into multiple groups. Now why it had splintered into multiple groups? It had splintered into multiple groups because the sub-leaders of Taliban, apart from this Mullah Umar, they wanted not to conduct any sort of negotiation with the United States of America. Plus, there is also an interwar that is going on between the Shia community and the Sunni community. Now these factors, they have multiplied the war in Afghanistan. And now Pakistan from about 2010 onwards has also begun to feel the heat of terrorism. Now here comes the question, is ISI capable enough to break up a peace deal between the Taliban forces and the government of Afghanistan? Now, is ISI still having the skill to rein in these terrorist forces? The answer is big no. Now, why the answer is no? Aaj ISI in terrorist forces ko kyun rein in nahi kar pa rahi hai? और क्यों रेन इन नहीं कर सकती है? The reason is these terrorist groups, they have grown in multiple numbers. Now ISI or Afghanistan or United States of America, it has not to deal with one terrorism, it has to deal with multiple terrorist outfits and groups. So it is becoming very very difficult to rein in this terrorism in this entire region. Now, after the death of Mullah Umar, Mr. Mansoor, he has taken over the reins of Taliban. But after the death of Mullah Umar, we have seen the rise of ISIS. We have seen the rise of Tariq-e-Taliban. We have seen the rise of terrorism related to Uzbekistan groups. We have seen the rise of the groups which wanted to create this entire enclave of Sunniism. So the complexity has increased, the equation has become more complex, the situation has become more volatile than it was about 5 to 6 years ago. So how can such a situation be tackled? Now this is a big question. Now the answer to this question is that the entire countries of the world, they should act in cooperation. They should work in coordination, they should work in unison, they should work collectively to tackle this menace, else it will become a specter of the sort in the future which would be very 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 hard to tackle. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, do click on the like button. Do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.